Thank you so much for this invitation. We're really privileged. And let me tell you, Kerala, you do make India incredible India. So like a big round of applause for Kerala Tourism, please come on this afternoon. I'm Elsie Gabriel. I'm the founder of Young Environmentalist Program Trust. We do environmental education and awareness activities for the youth and the student community all over the world. And I'm also a member of the Global World Tourism Sustainable Tourism Council. And Victor's also the director of the Young Environmentalist Program. And I've been trained on sustainable green lifestyle and climate change by former Vice President of USA, Mr. Al Gore. So it's sustainable tourism and ecotourism is something very, very close to my heart. I've been researching now. I will be shortly doing my PhD. And God help Kerala if I'm going to work my PhD on Kerala sustainable tourism. I need all your support and your backing. All right. So to get out of all the details here and why we are here, is what I enjoyed most was Victor and myself are like we said in the beginning, we are seasoned travelers. And you have at least 30% the world over of seasoned travelers nearing retirement, post-retirement, and who will invest in life experiences, engagements, and to take away with them before you age what your lifestyle, what your physical and mental health can give to the world and can take back from the world through travel. So 30% of that segment is what we represent. We've come to Kerala before, and that's why we came again, and we'll come again. So that segment I want to target when I leave from here. So that repetitive visitations. So having said that, what Victor and myself enjoyed most in all our tours was how at each place we engaged ourselves. Number one, Victor was very, very, got very close to the tourism police. I must congratulate the Kerala Tourism on elaborating and very well stationed tourism police, which was who was stationed there at the St. Angelo's Fort. He was there and he knew his history like the back of his hand. He knew, he took us for a tour and he took Victor especially right on the top of the fort, right inside all the prison cells and explained everything beautifully. We captured it on a video. So I think your USP number one should be protract, expand, focus on Kerala tourism. India is come under the scanner right now for safety, safety of women, girls and families. India, Bombay, Delhi, sorry, but these are the areas of focus. So you lead in safety and you must protract and expand and use that as a USP for Kerala tourism police. I have seen that in Israel. Victor and myself have traveled to over 28 countries and 55 destinations. And Israel was the only place where we saw tourism police. They sit in your bus and they escort your bus right throughout for safety at every checkpoint, every milestone. So you in India lead the way where tourism police is concerned. Use that on top of your focus and on your list. And you can use that as one of your norms for your awards. And also expand not only at that port, but try and expand tourism police all over your state. Use that example in all of your state. Make it larger than life. Make it a safety haven for tourists here in Kerala, Kerala with open arms. That's one point. And secondly, Victor just enjoys fishing. So fishing is something which is so vital and important here in Kerala. Of course, you have fishing nets. You have Chinese fishing nets, which are not Chinese. They are originally just on weight system and how it is shoreline fishing, right? But you can use your small talaus, the tanks, which are the villages. You can use your rivers. You can use your backwaters. You can also use your ocean. If you have a beautiful wharf, if you have a little bund, if you have a little platform, whether it is made out of bamboo or palm trees or cement or mud, you can make fishing another USP of Kerala tourism. Fishing through fishing rods, angling and fishing. So you have, it's a haven for fishing. So if you make a policy decision at your state level, government level, let's incorporate, let's change the bylaws, let's make a U-turn and make the whole coast, backwaters, inlet, estuaries, rivers into a paddling haven. That's one point you can pick up on fishing. Fishing rods today don't have to be very expensive. They can be made naturally. Kerala can make them from the bamboo, which is ample supply. So you have bamboo ample supply, that's very easy. You can have a fishing rod making workshop there. You can take them to the fishing rod making workshop. You can show how fishing is done, angling is done. This is the walk. And when your visitors get engaged, they are going to learn, not only learn a skill, they're going to be sharing memories of father and son, father and daughter, and the whole family. So you engage in making memories of fishing together. And have you ever felt a thrill in catching a fish? You know, you capture a fish and then you hook one and then you reel it in and you drag it, tie it out and again bring it back. It's the excitement, the thrill, the adrenal. I think fishing is something that Kerala can just use as a second USP point to you through our experiences. Okay, and besides fishing, we did fishing also on the boat cruise, on the boathouse. We did fishing and Victor did night fishing and he caught a fish. And the excitement on both of us, it was like celebration of each. I did cook that fish, I have too much respect for that fish. And of course there are laws all over the world which I will relate to you. I will give you a whole booklet. There's a size that you can catch, there's a catch and throw process, there's a catch and keep process, there are sizes, there are bylaws and everything. That's why I want to take you to take it up at a state policy level. It's very intense and it's very exciting as well. So we did not cook that fish, but yes, we took full advantage and we took the boat cruise. The captain was kind enough to stop at an island. So island hopping was just not island capturing photographs and sightseeing. We got off the island, we went to the market, we bargained as normal, not Indians, all over the world people bargain. And haggling and asking the names of the fish and is it fresh, kab pakra, kab, you know, kya hai naam and konsa and everything. And is it fresh water, is it sea water. So we did whole research on it. And then we chose black river crabs. They are very tasty. And they were alive. So we brought at least a kilo of black crabs back to the boat. We cut it and we cleaned it and we made Kerala masala. And we cooked it in the boathouse kitchen. And we all shared it, all of us, the crab curry. So we cooked the crab curry. And Vikram myself, not that I'm saying that we are seasoned travelers, so we must put in as much as impact. But there are a segment of group travelers. When you're mature travelers, you'd like to get out maximum. So what we went one step further and I dived even into the murky waters, river waters, where you can't see. I didn't have goggles, nothing like that, but I'm a paddy advanced diver. But I just went into the river water and fished out with the help of the captain. Mussels or clams? Clams or shells. And we took that out and cooked that as well. So these are, the USP is make the trips more engaging, like, you know, these cooking experiences and fishing experiences, okay? But last but not the least, as an environmentalist and as a fighter for the ocean, and also, you know, what is very close to my heart is climate change, and we do work for keeping our oceans and seas clean, is scuba diving. So I was so grateful to the Hotel Uday Samudra and to Mr. Jackson and to the Bond Safari Scuba Divers Center who took me to, with of course the ace, Kerala has the ace world famous scuba, Captain Shantanu. You must meet him, he is a world ace diver and it was a privilege. I have dived in Australia, Bali, Africa, Mauritius, Seychelles, Madagascar, Malaysia, you name it, I have dived. But diving with Shantanu in Kerala was the cherry on the cake. So what I'm trying to say here is Kerala has it. I want Kerala tourism to make, reinstate and revive your scuba diving attraction. I want scuba diving as two aspects, two USPs. One as an activity, thrilling, adrenaline rush, learning a skill, and all the scuba divers can be enhanced, centers can be enhanced with the best. If you've done it in the villages of Maharashtra, in Sindhubung district, which is very remote village, Kerala can do it because you're blessed with a mighty coast, very safe coast, and you're blessed with miles and miles of ocean with plenty of fish and education. So you can capture youth, you can capture world scuba divers as your next client target audience to get scuba diver setups going. And you can develop on the present ones as well. You can develop on that. And another aspect which can put Kerala on the world map of scuba divers is ocean cleanups. Shantanu, Captain Shantanu myself did do at least half an hour taking out plastics from the oceans. I have videos on that. So we clean the whole oceans for the plastic bags. So we can celebrate World Ocean Day cleaning plastic bags on the ocean side through scuba diving sites. So you have a dual two-pronged approach in your scuba diving setups. So that's how you can put the scuba diving tourist attraction on the world map of scuba divers and ocean cleanliness. That's one. And of course, I'd also like to say that through all these 10 places that we've seen and much more which Kerala Tourism has to offer, we can also set up international cultural exchange programs. I think you are in medical tourism, Ayurveda tourism, and I was very impressed with the Sagarlaya in Arts and Craft Village. I have already nominated them for an international award. And also Mandru Islands, also I have also nominated their name. So it is cultural exchange programs with interstate in India itself. I'm not saying foreign students later on. First India Education Minister, Education Departments, and then you get exchange students to come into. There are lakhs and lakhs of students all over the country have student exchange programs, educational programs with Kerala Tourism. You will hit a very huge target market audience. So students coming on an exchange program. As a founder of Young Environmentalists, that's what I can contribute to. And that's it. And congratulations, Kerala. You will be also seeing cruise ships this December. Mumbai is going to see cruise ships coming in to Mangalore and then to Kochi. So is Kerala ready? So if you're ready, we did the Caribbean cruises. We've done a lot of cruises. So when you come on shore, the cruise is going to hit Kerala. Kerala has to be ready to offer excitement. So scuba diving is what was offered in all our cruises. The moment we got off a ship, pictures, oceans, everything was taken. But how exciting is the destination that the cruise stops and going to make it for the cruisers. So Kerala, December, the first cruise is going to hit your shore. Scuba diving, I think, and snorkeling should be one of the excitements that the international and national, you can use that. Use the audience. There are thousands of audience inside those cruise ships, so use that to focus on your scuba diving and your other aspects of also. And of course, a big message is that we can see more garbage bags, more garbage containers. If Kerala Tourism can use your branding and just put it in the whole of the state. Wet garbage, dry garbage, the entire state. And every traveler that comes in knows the segregation at levels all over. So at the shore, sometimes at the entrance of, say, a simple Alappi beach, gorgeous beach, so clean, so nice, but the approach was full of garbage bottles, beer bottles, and glass. I can get cut, I can have a lot of diseases, and if anyone sees that, domestic clients as well as international, you're going to get put off at the approach road. So at the approach systems, use Kerala Tourism branding, protect that as advertising and marketing, but use it again as garbage bins, huge, larger than life, which will be all over the state, and you portray and you also recycle. That's one thing. And last but not the least, I'm a huge enforcer of ban on plastic bags, and I request Kerala Tourism to take the lead. If you have taken lead, Kerala and Trivandrum Airport has taken the lead internationally to go solar, right? Your airport is the only one in the world which has gone fully solar. I hear about it all the time in all my international conferences. So I think Kerala Tourism, let's put it on the map of India, incredible India, just not the world, that ban plastic bags in all the airports. Have the scanning, have your Kerala host garlanding people to welcome and say, ma'am, no plastic bags allowed in our state. Train junction, bus junctions, everywhere, go on a blanket ban, lead. Kerala Tourism can lead by putting a ban on plastic bags and making Kerala Tourism one of the best industries among all the industries here in Kerala. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you everyone. I mean, great to see this excitement. I think everybody had so